Welcome to Warn. Today's top stories are: France's Dassault to bring in largest defense FDI via Rafale JV with Reliance Defence. The largest defense sector foreign direct investment, FDI, is coming soon via French aircraft manufacturer Dassault. The investment is part of Dassault's obligations on Make in India commitments under the Rafale fighter jet deal. These commitments require the French company to manufacture a significant part of the aircraft in India. The investment, intended for manufacturing of aircraft components for global markets, will come into the Dassault-Reliance Aerospace Limited, DRAL, joint venture set up to meet offset obligations for the Rs 58,000 crore deal. The first tranche of FDI, around Rs 200 crore, is likely to come in by July. Dassault will emerge as a single largest FDI investor in the defense sector. It will far exceed all FDI till date in the defense sector in India. The cumulative FDI in the defense sector in India till date is of the order of $6 million, Rajesh K. Dhingra, President, Reliance Defense and Aerospace, told ET. The JV will be used for creating infrastructure at the Maihan, Nagpur, facility, with a groundbreaking ceremony planned for the end of July. Teams from the French company have visited the site at least 4 times in the past 3 months to finalize project plans. Groundbreaking is planned in July and we expect the first article to roll out in the first quarter of 2018. Currently, first batch of our team is undergoing training at Dassault facilities in France, Dhingra added. Government clearances would not be required for the inflow as it will be under the automatic route for FDI given that Reliance Defence holds 51% of the JV. Reliance Defence is bullish on the aviation and naval sectors and is targeting potential contracts worth over 2 lakh crore that are expected to come up for bidding in the next 24 months. This includes new submarines and amphibious ships for the Navy, over 260 single and twin engine fighters and a variety of helicopters needed by the three armed forces. The plan is to set up a 100-acre facility that will integrate a supply chain for the Rafale fighter jet in India. DRAL has announced that the first phase of the project will generate more than 700 highly skilled direct jobs and 2,800 indirect jobs. IISc Carolina designs UAV to help detect radiation remotely. Gathering data from areas where there is suspected leakage of radioactive material is now less risky. An unmanned aerial vehicle, UAV, developed by researchers at the Indian Institute of Science, IISc Carolina, can now detect nuclear radiation from a distance without having to put human lives at risk. This UAV, developed by researchers and students of Aerospace Engineering Department at IISc Carolina, can be deployed at the spot to detect radiations that have been emitted and the extent to which damage could be expected. This was developed as part of a project that was funded by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. Fitted with sensors that can pick up beta and gamma radiations that are known to be dangerous to life, information gathered will be transmitted to a ground station that is at least 2 kilometers away. Weighing about 4 kilograms, the UAV can fly for 60 minutes at a stretch post takeoff covering a range of 10 kilometers. Speaking about the project, Drive S.N. Amkar, Chief Research Scientist, Control and Guidance, Department of Aerospace Engineering, said that a prototype is ready and has been tested along the Shavara coast in Kerala. Not only can this UAV transmit real-time data on the presence of radiation and its strength, but it can also relay visuals from a camera that has been fitted to it. It will help us gather data. In case there is a leakage, rescue operations could also be aided through this, said Dr. Amkar. The device is fitted with GPS that will gather data based on the location and GPRS that enables transmitting the perceived signals to another system. Students working on the project explained that the UAV is designed in a fashion that it could be destroyed at the spot if it is affected by radiation. Sometimes, if the radiation level is too high, bringing it back could prove dangerous, said Srihari V.S., a student working on the project. Students from the Department of Aerospace, electronics and mechanical engineering worked on this project for over 2 years now. A drone controlled by brain signals, yet another UAV designed by IISc Carolina, functions based on electric signals captured by the brain. With the signal of one's brain, the UAV moves in the desired direction. An encephalogram, a device that appears like a headset, gathers data and sends it to the computer, which later converts it into commands for the drone to move. Professor's bulletproof jackets designed for the Indian Army could save Rs 20,000 crores. For the first time in 70 years, Indian Army personnel will be equipped with bulletproof jackets manufactured completely by homegrown technology. Designed by Professor Dr. Shantanu Bhaumik, head of Department of Aerospace Engineering at Coimbatore-based Amrita University, the jacket has passed the test of approval from the Ministry of Defence. Falling under the Make in India project, the jacket was designed using indigenous technology, involving lightweight thermoplastics. The current expenditure for each jacket used by military and paramilitary services is around 1.5 lakh and are imported from the United States. The project, once given the green signal by the PM's office, will involve a joint partnership between the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, and the Defense Ministry. Each of Dr. Bhaumik's jackets is expected to cost about 50,000, according to TOI. The move could help India save 20,000 crore every year. The perks of the new jacket will be its weight and air conditioning ability. The present ones that are worn by all personnel belonging the Army, BSF, CRPF and police are very heavy at around 15 to 18 kilograms. Weighing around 1.5 kilograms, the new lightweight jackets with its 20 layers lined with carbon fiber, will enable our folks in uniform to work in extreme harsh temperatures extending up to 57 degrees Celsius as well. According to TOI, Professor Bhaumik is elated about his invention gaining official approval and thanked former Deputy Chief of Army Staff Lieutenant Gen Subrata Saha, who had played a role in encouraging Bhaumik. He also dedicated his invention to Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Indian Navy P-8I Fleet achieves 10,000 hours, commended for outstanding performance. Boeing congratulates the Indian Navy and Indian Naval Air Squadron 312 ASP, 8I fleet on achieving 10,000 flight hours since induction in 2015 and for receiving the Chief of Naval Staff's unit citation for outstanding operational performance. The Indian Navy operates 8 P-8I aircraft for long-range maritime reconnaissance and anti-submarine warfare missions and has ordered 4 additional P-8I aircraft, for which deliveries will begin in 2020. AMCA, is Air Force paying for its short-sightedness in fighter acquisition plans? An idea of developing MCA, medium combat aircraft, was floated even before the first prototype of LCA Tejas made its maiden flight in early 2000s. Initial rendering of MCA showed twin-engined, tail-less design, strike-optimized medium combat aircraft, MCA, aircraft which could have complemented LCA and Su-30 MKI as India's leading combat planes. Revised rendered images shown MCA with a more conventional design, which could be 4++ non-stealth fighter jet envisioned as a replacement for the British Jaguar and Mirage 2000. This idea didn't find any backers in the Indian Air Force, and for years it remained in the back burner since MMRCA tender to acquire 126 advanced 4++ generation fighter jets took precedence, while MMRCA tender stretched well over a decade only to end with TOICAN order for only 36 Dassault Rafale fighter jet. India now plans 2 separate tenders for single-engine and twin-engine fighter jet, which both will be used largely to replace retired MiG-21 and MiG-27s. 12-ton MCA could have enjoyed maximum commonality between LCA in terms of some systems and subsystems and other aspects like engines, radars and avionics. While Indian Air Force continues to have desires for more Dassault Rafale, India had an opportunity to build its own fighter capable of Rafale in terms of capabilities. In 2017 we could have started production of MCA along with LCA Tejas, which could have come as major boost to fighter acquisition plans of Indian Air Force, While its developers could have initiated development of fifth-generation AMCA, which could have served our future requirements, but the reality is that even in 2017 we are searching for a 4++ generation fighter which can be manufactured in India, while plans to develop a fifth-generation fighter with Russia is in doldrums and development of AMCA is yet to take off officially. India to get long-range missile test facilities in Indian Ocean. India's Defence Research and Development Organisation, DRDO, has got governmental approval to set up the country's land-based long-range missile facility at South Andaman's Rutland Island, which is some 200 kilometres from the Strait of Malacca that connects the Indian Ocean to the South China Sea. India's National Board of Wildlife cleared the proposal sent by DRDO in 2012 for creating infrastructure facilities for strategic surveillance system at Rutland Island. Facility will have a missile test range for testing of long-range missile. After discussions, considering the strategic importance of the project for the country's defense, the standing committee decided to recommend the proposal along with the conditions and mitigation measures prescribed by the State Chief Wildlife Warden. A document released by India's Ministry of Environment and Forests said. The proposal involves diversion of 49.978 acres forest, of which 0.84 hectare falls in the Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park and 49.138 hectare reserve forest within 10 kilometers of the eco-sensitive zone. Currently, Indian scientists test long-range missiles from the Odisha coast and are tracked by naval vessels on a trajectory into the Bay of Bengal. Work on technology demonstration vessel for DRDO, which is capable of tracking the full flight of long-range naval missile systems during test firing, has been in progress at the Cochin shipyard. On May 16 this year, the Narendra Modi government had also cleared the Indian Navy proposal to expand Shibpur Naval Air Station in the northern part of the Andaman Island. Indian Armed Forces operate Dornier, Mi-8, Chetak aircraft from NAS Shibpur Airfield, which after the expansion would be approximately 100 hectares and serve larger aircraft. The Indian Armed Forces have been expanding their strength at strategically important Andaman and Nicobar Islands since long. In March this year, the Indian Navy had commissioned the first of its 8 amphibious landing craft at Tri-Service Command Headquarters in Port Blair. India also has an IAF base at Car Nicobar, named Karnak Air Force Base and Naval Base Kardip, located on Kamarta Island, a part of the Nangkauri group of islands. Indian Army working on mega order of Dhanush artillery guns, report with the smooth conclusion of all major user trials of 6 Dhanush artillery guns by India Army, IDRW.org has been informed by reliable industrial sources that after the initial order of 114 155mm/45, caliber Dhanush howitzer gun, Indian Army is working on second mega order deal to acquire more Dhanush artillery guns soon. Indian Army is likely to place an order for 300 more Dhanush artillery guns soon over the initial order of 114 guns which are already in production by Ordnance Factory Board, OFB. Initial orders for 114 guns will be concluded by 2019. With production rate of Dhanush artillery guns to touch 60 per annum in 2019, bulk order FO300 guns will require nearly 5 years for completion of the order, but Indian Army is reportedly happy with proposed production timelines since major chunk of orders will likely be reserved for 155mm, 52 caliber towed advanced towed artillery gun system, ATAGS, artillery gun developed by DRDO with private defense sector companies. ATAGS is currently going through developmental trials which soon will see first few prototypes been handed over to Indian Army to begin user trials which will commence rigorous integration and a testing cycle which can last for nearly 3 years before Army places an initial order for the new ultra-modern artillery gun. Large-scale induction and production will commence from 2024 onwards and Army might be inducting nearly 1500 plus guns over a decade which might see first private defense production orders. OFB already has developed 55mm, 52 caliber version of the Dhanush artillery guns which already has cleared internal company trials, is also on offer to Indian Army to commence user trials if interest is shown by Indian Army. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.